Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. Thank you for watching this video. And for today's case, I bring you a story that is going to make you furious. And when I say furious, I mean for those who are opposed to the death penalty. This case will probably make you think, well, these two deserve it. Yep, today I bring you the murder, I mean the cruel torture and murder of a two-year-old toddler, first known as Baby Grace, but her real name is Riley Ann Sawyers. So let's get started. I want to warn you, there are details on how Riley Ann was tortured and killed that will shock you. First and foremost, these details are abhorrent, but we're going to start with just because you can reproduce, that doesn't mean you should. And once again, crimes against children are still, till this day, downplayed. And what will shock you the most is the fact that one person could have walked away and removed Riley from that situation, but chose the other person instead. Let's go. Riley Ann Sawyers was born on March 11, 2005 in Mentor, Ohio. Her parents, Kimberly Down Trenner and Robert Thomas Sawyers, were high school sweethearts. Kimberly got pregnant as a teenager and she lived with Robert and Cheryl, Robert's mother and Riley Ann's primary caregiver. Riley Ann's father described her as a little girl with big imagination who could play and have fun with anything. With time, Riley Ann's parents ended the relationship but still lived together in the same house with Cheryl. In 2006, Robert left the house because Kimberly filed a charge against him for domestic violence. Eventually, Robert met another woman whom he married later on. Early 2007, Kimberly met Royce Ziegler while playing an online game. Then, in May 2007, Kimberly moved to Texas so Kimberly could be with Royce, and she took Riley Ann too. They started living together, married in June 2007. Everything started fine. Royce supported both Kimberly and Riley Ann, but things didn't last long at all. In less than just 2 months, one of them would be dead. Royce didn't interfere on how Kimberly disciplined Riley Ann until he started to have an opinion, a pretty violent one. To Kimberly, Riley Ann had a behavioral issue, so Royce suggested she should start spanking Riley Ann. And later, he suggested she should use a leather belt. Royce's mother noticed Riley Ann's bottom was bruised, so she advised them to use hands and not the belt. But would Kimberly and Royce follow that advice? What do you think? Nope, Royce had a different plan. A couple months passed and both Cheryl and Royce's family hadn't seen Riley Ann. Royce's family asked about her and both Kimberly and Royce told them Riley Ann was with Kimberly's aunt and uncle because of an ongoing custody battle. On October 2007, a container was found by a fisherman in Galveston Bay. He called the authorities. Inside the container, there were remains of an unknown child. The police wasn't able to identify the remains. Autopsy revealed the remains had 3 skull fractures. It had injuries similar to falling from a rooftop. The investigation moved as a homicide. A forensic sketch was created. Authorities released it to the public nationwide to see if anyone recognized the little girl they called Baby Grace. Cheryl Sawyer saw the sketch on TV and it looked a lot like her granddaughter Riley Ann, so she contacted the authorities. She stated she had not seen her granddaughter for months and that Baby Grace looked a lot like her grandbaby Riley Ann. Authorities decided to do a welfare check on Riley Ann. They talked to Royce Ziegler, who said there was an ongoing custody dispute with Riley's biological father. He said a representative of the Department of Child Protective Services had come and taken Riley to Ohio, and that Riley was with Cheryl or Cheryl's sister. Kimberly also said the same story. They actually had a letter from CPS which they handed to the authorities. But the thing is, authorities found out there was no open CPS case on Riley Ann in Ohio. Initially, authorities believed the story about Riley, but then became suspicious because Kimberly became uncooperative and didn't seem to want to file a police report regarding Riley Ann's disappearance. Kimberly was then contacted to provide DNA sample to eliminate Riley Ann as baby Grace. So eventually, Kimberly must have realized she was at a dead end. So, on November 27, 2007, Kimberly went to the sheriff's office where she admitted baby Grace was indeed Riley Ann, and she gave a videotaped statement where she recounts what had happened to Riley Ann. DNA testing confirmed baby Grace was Riley Ann Sawyers, and she was beaten to death by her mother, Kimberly, and her husband, Royce Ziegler. Everything started with Royce Ziegler believing Riley Ann should say sir or ma'am to adults. She should say thank you and please. He also believed physical abuse was the right way to discipline a child. That was the way he was brought up by his violent father. Royce Ziegler was no different. Because he didn't think Kimberly was doing a proper job on physically abusing her daughter, on July 25th, 2007, Royce Ziegler decided to stay home to make sure Kimberly was disciplining Riley the right way, the violent way. The ordeal lasted all day. The end game was death. In that morning, everything started when Riley said, "I want," instead of, "Please, can I have?" Kimberly had to use the belt, not tell Royce yourself, "I'm leaving and taking my 2-year-old innocent child." Kimberly actually used the belt. Royce stated they needed to break Riley Ann. They used the belt throughout the day to beat up Riley. Royce beat up Riley every time she screamed or when she didn't say or do what he wanted. Royce then started to shove Riley's face into a pillow, and he told Kimberly to run cold water in the bathtub. Every time Riley Ann didn't say or do what Royce wanted, he would hit her with the belt and then shove Riley's head under the water. Riley was naked during the beating. Royce wanted to beat her with her skin exposed, you know, to sink in better the information. They put ice packs to soothe her bruised body and gave her Tylenol. And Kimberly never picked up her daughter and left. Kimberly thought the beating had stopped, but instead, Royce started beating Riley Ann with a thicker leather belt as hard as he could. He was in a mission: break a 2-year-old toddler. Royce's violence escalated. He grabbed Riley by her hair, dragged her to put her under the cold water. When Riley would run, he would put the belt around her neck and drag her. Royce picked up Riley and threw her across the room several times, and he also bit Riley. Kimberly didn't call the police. She just let this guy she had met a few months prior to violently attack her daughter. Riley told Kimberly she loved her when it was Kimberly's turn to beat Riley up with the belt. But Royce told Kimberly she was being manipulated. Riley Ann came in to a point when she couldn't stand up anymore. But Royce stated she was pretending. Royce told Kimberly to get Tylenol, but Riley couldn't swallow or chew. Kimberly allegedly told Royce Riley needed help and needed to go to the hospital. Royce said no because they would go to jail. Riley then stopped breathing. Royce performed CPR. Riley's heart was beating, but she wasn't breathing. They thought she was choking, but Riley didn't gag when they put their fingers down her throat. Kimberly sat on the couch. Royce put Riley on Kimberly's arms. Riley Ann's heart stopped beating, and she died in the arms of an evil monster that gave birth to her. Royce then put Riley's body in the bathtub and covered it with a towel. They cleaned everything up and got rid of the belts and the pillow. Then they went to Walmart. They bought a plastic storage container, a chain, quick dry cement, bleach, plastic gloves, trash bags, a clip to fasten the chain, and a shovel. It was a clean-up murder kit, no question about it. Royce used the plastic gloves. He scrubbed Riley Ann's body with bleach. He poured bleach into Riley's mouth and throat. They dressed Riley. They put Riley into trash bags. They put her little body into a container with a mix of quick dry cement and placed the container in a storage shed where it stayed for 2 months. They tried to dispose of the body twice until they dumped it in Galveston Bay. When baby Grace's body was discovered, Royce told Kimberly to forge a letter from the Department of Children's Services stating she had been removed from her custody because Royce had allegedly abused her. They also disposed of Riley's belongings. After this confession, Royce was arrested and he stated Kimberly had done it. Both of them were charged with capital murder and tampering with evidence. Both of these two evil monsters went to trial, and on February 2, 2009, Kimberly Trenor was found guilty of capital murder and sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole. She was 19 years old. On November 6, 2009, Royce was found guilty of capital murder and tampering with evidence. He was sentenced to life in prison without parole. He was 24 years old. And this is how the brutal death of Riley Ann came to unfold. And what are your thoughts on the death penalty right now? Do these two deserve to be on death row?